Nylon was developed in 1935, and today we find it in everything from clothing to parachutes. But do you know what it's made of? Hi, my name is Jenny. I'm a chemist here at the University of Minnesota, and today I'm going to tell you about the chemistry of nylon. Nylon is a polymer, which means that each molecule of nylon is essentially a long chain made up of small molecules called monomers. To make nylon, we combine two different types of monomers, an acid or an acid chloride, and an amine. When these chemical groups react, they form a link called a peptide bond. Because the monomers have reactive groups on both ends, they can keep linking up to form long polymer chains. Let's head into the lab and give it a try. In this demo, we've put one monomer, the amine, into water. We've put the other monomer, the acid, into cyclohexane. Like the oil and vinegar in a salad dressing, water and cyclohexane don't mix, so if we pour them together carefully, they form two layers with the cyclohexane on top. So now, we have the amine down here, and the acid up here. And guess what's happening at the interface? They're reacting to form a polymer. In fact, there's already a layer of nylon polymer in there. Let's see if we can grab onto it and pull it out. Hey, there it is. It's nylon. And it keeps getting longer. As soon as I pull up some of the nylon, more polymer forms at the interface. So we can keep going and going and going. I don't know about you, but I think that's pretty cool. We took two liquids made up of small molecules and turned them into a long row simply by linking the molecules up end to end and forming a polymer. Here at the University of Minnesota, we make and study all sorts of polymers, from polymers that might be useful in medicine or electronics, to ones that are nice and strong when you need them, but compost away when you're done. Are there any types of polymers that you would like to learn about? Leave us a note in the comments and let us know. Thanks for watching.